Hello and welcome to part 2 of features of Kubernetes. In the earlier session, we have learned about automatic bin packing, service discovery and load balancing, storage orchestration, and self-healing. So these are the features we covered in part 1 of the features of Kubernetes. In this session, we will cover rest of the features of Kubernetes. So let's start on this awesome journey to learn the features of Kubernetes. I'm Raghav. I'm a teacher and you can find all my work on my website automationstepbystep.com. In this session, we will learn about the features of Kubernetes, and this is part 2 of the features of Kubernetes session. In this session, we are going to go very basic step by step and learn automated rollouts and rollbacks, secret and configuration management, batch execution and horizontal scaling. And do not worry if you have no prior knowledge or you do not know anything about these terms. I will go very basic from scratch and we will go up step by step. So these are the four features we covered in part one. So just in case you have not watched part one of this session, I will request you to watch that first. And then we will start with the feature number 5 in this session, that is automated rollouts and rollbacks. Kubernetes can manage rollouts and rollbacks in an automated way. And before we know that, let us understand what is rollout and rollback. Whenever we make any changes to the application or we deploy new changes or new features to our application, that is called as rollout. And just in case we have to revert those changes and we have to restore the application to the previous state, that is called as rollback. Now, Kubernetes takes care of rollout and rollback in an automated way, and it does all this while taking care that there is no downtime of the application or the process. So Kubernetes can progressively roll out the changes to the application, and while it is rolling out these changes, it also monitors the application, and just in case if there are any issues or something goes wrong, it will roll back, and all this time the application will be up, there will be no downtime. So this was the feature of automated rollouts and rollback. The next feature is secret and configuration management. In Kubernetes, we have two objects, secrets and config maps. Now, secret is an object in Kubernetes that handles the sensitive data like passwords, keys, tokens, etc. And config map is an object in Kubernetes that handles the configurations. So secrets is a Kubernetes object, and secret is created outside pods and containers. If you look at this image, we have already seen about pods, containers and node in a brief in the earlier session. So inside a node, they can be one or multiple pods, and inside a pod, they can be one or multiple containers. And secret is managed and created outside the pods and containers. In the same way, config map is a Kubernetes object, and it is created and managed outside the pods and containers. Now the advantage here is because these are located outside and not coupled with pods or containers, it is easy to manage both the sensitive data as well as the configurations. They are portable and easy to manage. So in simple words, secrets is a Kubernetes object that separates sensitive data from pods and containers, and config map is a Kubernetes object that separates configurations from pods and containers. So with this feature in Kubernetes, we can manage secrets and configurations separately from the image, and also it helps to deploy and update the secrets and configurations without rebuilding the image. Some important and useful things: secret and configurations are stored separately in a data store called etcd or etcd. So etcd is a key value data store or database, and there is a limit for secrets. The max size limit for secret is 1 MB. So this is some important information you can remember, and this was secret and configuration management feature. The next feature is batch execution. Now batch job requires an executable or a process to run to completion, and in Kubernetes, we have run to completion jobs, which are used for batch processing. And each job can create one or more pods based on the requirements. And during the job execution, in case any container or pod fails, it will be rescheduled on any other available node, and job controller will take care of all this. In case required, it can also run multiple pods in parallel and can scale up if required. And once the job is completed, the pod will move from running state to a shutdown state. Now, with all these features, the feature of batch execution in Kubernetes support batch execution long-running jobs and replaces failed containers. So this was the feature of batch execution. Then we have horizontal scaling. So in Kubernetes, we can do scaling and scale up and scale down of containers. Now scale up means to create more replicas of the containers if required, and scale down means to kill the containers in case these containers are not required. And in Kubernetes, this scaling up and scaling down of containers can be done using commands or using the UI or the dashboard, and it can also be taken care automatically based on the CPU usage. Now, to understand this in a more deeper way, there are three tools or structures in Kubernetes: replication controller, manifest file, and horizontal pod scaler. Now, what is a replication controller? Replication controller is a structure that enables to create multiple pods, and it will make sure that these number of pods always exist. So in case any pod crashes, replication controller will replace it, and replication controller gets the information about the number of pods to create and make available always from a file that is called as manifest file. So if you look at this image from the manifest file, in the manifest file there is a property or a information called replicas, and there is a count there. So if it says replicas 3, replication controller will create and manage 3 replicas of the pod. Replication controller is also abbreviated as RC or RCS, and it will ensure that the desired number of pods are always maintained. Now we also have another tool or structure called horizontal pod autoscaler. Now horizontal pod autoscaler will monitor the CPU utilization, and based on this metrics, it can send a message to replication controller or set the number of pods required, and based on that, replication controller will maintain that number of pods. So there is a controller manager in horizontal pod autoscaler which loops every 15 seconds. 15 seconds is the default time, it can be changed, and it keeps on monitoring the CPU utilization, and based on those metrics, it can send the signal to replication controller to maintain the number of pods. So this was about horizontal scaling. This feature says that Kubernetes can scale up or scale down the containers using commands or from dashboard or automatically based on the CPU usage. So these are the 8 major features of Kubernetes. I hope all these features are now very clear to you. You can watch these videos over and over again if you have any doubts. And in this session, we covered automated rollouts and rollbacks, secret and configuration management, batch execution, and horizontal scaling. In the coming session, we will learn the architecture of Kubernetes. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.